Welcome to the Seniors Rock Show, presented by the Law Office of Michael Robinson, PC, on News Radio, Wham 1180. The Seniors Rock Show, a lively weekly discussion, shining a bright light on aging with fun, entertainment, and important info for all adults. Join in with your comments or questions. Call or text 222-1180 or 1-800-295-1180. Now from the News Radio Wham 1180 studio in downtown Rochester, here's your host, Joanna Palvino.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Seniors Rock Show. We're really glad you're joining us today, and we really feel first of all, before we get into the show, I'd like to let you know that it is, you should feel free to call. And I don't even know, you know, Pam, can people text us? I don't even know. 222-1180? No, just call. Just those people during the week, the big guys get to text. So, but feel free to call. This is a talk show, and I like to talk, as you can see, and I'm quite sure that Michael Robinson, or Mike Robinson, as we call him, my sidekick here every week, enjoys a bit of good-natured banter, too. So pick up the phone, Pam will answer, and join us anytime you'd like to in the next hour. You are why we are here every week. And I'll tell you the numbers again. We tell you all the time, 222-1180, and that is area code 585, and 1-800-295-1180 if you're out of town or out of the country. And to give you listeners some variety with some good information thrown in. Each week we have at least one guest, and this week you get a bonus because we've got two. So we're going to have, first we'll visit with Deneen Nucci. She is with the Village at Unity, and she's another one of those lifers, Mike, that is from this vibrant senior community that we've heard from many times before in the last year. And they're all passionate. These are people who stay forever. So we'll talk about that later. And then we've got a new venue to tell you about, an event venue. And there seems to be a lack of those. I know when people are getting married, they seem to be clamoring for a place to go. So we got a new place to tell you about. For music and for special events, 75 Stutzen Street. And they're going to, we got a guy here who thought about it as a dream and he made it a reality. His name is Tom Bruce, and he will be with us in the next hour as well. And this unique new venue is right here in Rochester, down the street from me in the Charlotte neighborhood by the lake. So Pam and Mike, I can see that they're raring to go here. So I'm going to stop talking and get moving with them. And Mike, I guess we'll start with what's the basics of estate planning today? You've been giving us lessons each week. That's been really cool. I like the way you chunked it down. So happy Saturday. What's happening?
There we go. Turn the microphone on. Happy Saturday, Joanna and Pam. And
hello, wake up over there.
There you go. It's a beautiful Saturday. And of course, everybody's getting excited because of the playoff game, the preseason game. I see Pam's got some Bills gear on, and
yeah,
a lot of folks are going to be watching that today or listening, as the case may be. But yeah, what a week. I tell you, it just flew by. You were asking me earlier what I did this week, and I can't even remember.
Yeah, I know. It is going by quickly. I think we have that pressure of summer's almost over. Is it the 22nd of August? I think that's end of summer. Or is it September?
September, right.
It is September.
So we've got, in the last several years, Septembers here have been really nice. So we've got a good bit of summer to come.
Yeah. Is it okay to say Indian summer still, or is that bad?
I don't know.
We'll find out.
I don't know.
I would like to get some of our Native American friends on the air, actually, from... I'm going to try to say that. Ganon. Can you tell me how to say that?
Ganondagan?
Yeah, Ganondagan.
That's a fabulous site. If
love
people
it.
Haven't visited
yes.
there, it really is mm-hmm. wonderful. Mm-hmm. But, you know, picking
Jemison.
Up on the basics of estate planning, you're right. It's something that we want to do and just kind of get everybody up to speed. And we started with a discussion of what is an estate. And we discovered that we all have an estate, and that estate consists of everything that we own. And last week we looked at what happens with our estate without a proper estate plan when we become unable to manage our own affairs. Because although many people think estate planning only applies at death, it very much also applies when we're incapacitated. And as we saw last week, managing our affairs when we're unable to do so for ourselves can become a difficult, expensive, and stressful situation for us and our family. But as I promised last week, that this week I would explain what's the planning that you can do to avoid those problems. So let's take a look at what we can do. And Joanna, there's really two tools that you can use to plan for your incapacity and make things as smooth as possible for your loved ones. First, you can execute a document called a durable power of attorney. This is a legal document that allows you to appoint someone called your agent to manage your affairs. And it's called a durable power of attorney because it remains in effect when you become incapacitated. And not all powers of attorney are drafted to be durable, so you want to be sure such a provision is included in your power of attorney document if you want your agent to be able to act for you when you're incapacitated. Also, if you want your agent to be able to act for you when you're incapacitated and not able to act for yourself, generally you'll want to include very broad powers for that person. And for that reason, you really want to be careful regarding who you name to be your agent. As we've talked about here on the show a number of times, it's quite easy for a power of attorney agent to abuse their position and harm you financially. So you want to give careful consideration to whom you appoint, and you want to be as sure as you can that the person you're naming is absolutely trustworthy. And, you know, Joanna, many people will just name their children in birth order to serve as agents without really considering whether they are the right choice. And many times they'll do that because they don't want to upset the older child. But I can tell you that the problems that result from naming the wrong agent are going to be worse than the problems that might arise because a child is upset that they're not the one appointed. And frankly, if that child is going to be upset if they're not named as agent, to me, that's an indication they're probably not the right choice.
Yeah, big red flag.
Indeed, indeed. And so durable power of attorney is an important document that really almost everyone should have, but it may not be the best strategy for incapacity planning when it comes to assets. And that's because many financial institutions refuse to honor powers of attorney. And they'll give many reasons for not honoring the power of attorney, including, well, it's too old, or it's not on their form that their lawyers have approved, or any number of other reasons, none of which are legally valid, but this is what people run into. And of course, I talk regularly with local attorneys as well as with attorneys around the country, and this continues to be a problem, even in states like New York that have laws intended to alleviate the problem. And so for almost all of the folks I meet with, a better approach is to create a trust to own your assets. And similar to a durable power of attorney, you can remain in full control of the assets while you're able to manage your affairs, and you name someone who we call a successor trustee to manage the trust assets for you when you're not able to do so. But for various reasons, and many of them valid reasons, financial institutions are more willing to work with trustees than they are with a power of attorney agent, which means your family is going to have a much easier time managing your assets with a trust if you're incapacitated. And Joanna, as you know, we go into much more detail about trusts in our educational webinar than we're able to do, you know, here on the show.
Yeah, and I was thinking while you were talking that there's all these labels and there's, you know, the documents and then there's the people that have labels, you know, for the different things in estate planning. And if you're out there and you're hearing this maybe for the first or maybe even second or third time, and it feels a little confusing, it is something that needs to be done by an attorney that knows what they're doing. So my point is, if you'd like to know more about it, because I think it's really important to do that, you can learn about it in an estate planning and elder law webinar, as Mike said, and you can meet him in person. It's a free 90-minute estate planning webinar, and the next one is on Wednesday, August 31st, and that's at 2 o'clock. And basically, if I pull this all together in my head, I'll tell someone, you're going to learn how to safeguard your assets. You're going to keep your affairs, you know, how to keep your affairs private. I know a lot of folks, you know, are concerned about that, and that you can be sure your estate goes to where you want it to go without, here's the key, going to court. And that's called probate. So I've learned a lot in the last few months about these things, and, you know, enough to be dangerous, but enough to tell people and to stress more than ever that you need to talk to an attorney that knows what they're doing, keeping these things up to date. Mike, I know you look at the laws constantly because they change just like everything else in our world. And folks, if you do want to sign up for that for the webinar on August 31st, it's simple. You just go to mrobinsonlaw.com, or you can call 374-5210. And that's area code 585. And again, easy, mrobinsonlaw.com. There's a little button right on that page that you land on, and you just sign up. And I'll make a little note. It's great to be on there when he's live and you can ask questions or hear other people. But if you can't do it, Mike, you can actually get a link right from you folks.
That is correct. Call us or visit the website and request it, and we can send a link.
Yep. So easy, easy. All right. You're listening to Seniors Rock Radio on News Radio WHAM 1180. We're going to go to break, but stay tuned. We're going to be back in a few minutes with Deneen from the Village at Unity. It's going to be fun. Stay right there. Our area's first direct primary care practice, Athena Direct Primary Care and Lifestyle Medicine, is open. Direct primary care is an innovative alternative to traditional corporate-style primary care, where you pay a monthly membership fee. There are no fee-for-service payments, no third-party billing. So less paperwork leaves time for extraordinary direct access to your own private physician, a members-only phone line, and unlimited, unhurried appointments. And other services are included too. That's all for one low rate. Athena Direct Primary Care is accepting new patients for a limited time only. Book your free meet and greet with Dr. Laura Petrescu today. Learn about this wonderful new practice, including membership benefits and the costs, at athenadirectcare.com. That's athenadirectcare.com. Or you can call. It's 585-662-5510.
There's mosquitoes on the river, fish are rising up like birds. It's been hot for 7 weeks now, too hot to even speak now. Did you hear what I just heard?
Ooh, I was just getting into that, and it probably goes on for about 45 minutes, so I guess it's good to stop now. Grateful Dead, thank you, Mike Robinson. And we're here with the Seniors Rock Radio Show, or you're here with us, and I'm your host, Joanna Palvino. And joining us now is Deneen Nucci. Deneen is a sales advisor at the Village at Unity. She was born and raised in Greece, New York, and that's right around the corner from me. She worked at the Village at Unity for close to 18 years now, and she started in the food service department and transitioned to her current role as a sales advisor about 4 years ago. So Deneen often says with enthusiasm, I love what I do. She's really peppy and excited about her job, and she's really proud of her son too. And he apparently just graduated from Penn State Law School. So congratulations. Deneen is continuing to enjoy life in Greece, New York, along with her husband and their cat, Newman. And I want to say right now, I don't know what your husband's name is, but welcome, Deneen. Hello.
Thank you, Joanne. How are you today?
Hi, good. We're in a little feisty mood here, as you can see. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Thank you for having me today.
Awesome. Well, thanks for being here. You know, Deneen, I know you get a lot of questions from folks considering a move to the Village at Unity. Let's talk about two of the most common questions you hear. You know, when is it time to make a move, and where do I start? So how do people identify? When is the right time?
Yeah, the right time is actually going to be a little different for everyone. You know, a move to an independent living community really is a lifestyle choice, or it could be a safety issue with the home. You know, stairs tend to, you know, be a dangerous situation. And, you know, for everybody, it's different. The right time looks different. But most people decide to make the move when, you know, the home is something that they just don't want to handle anymore, or, again, is just too much for them. But another big contributing factor is isolation, loneliness, I know some people just want a more fulfilled life. And so it's a very personal decision, and it's different for everyone. But those are some of the contributing factors.
Yeah, it's a lifestyle choice, really, you know, unless it is, like you said, you need assistance. Before we get a little more into this, Denise, tell the folks what levels of care you offer there at the Village at Unity.
Yeah, so we have a great full continuum of care. We offer independent living as well as assisted living and then memory care should that ever be a need down the road. So our residents, you know, they have the opportunity to start in independent living. And then as their needs change and they, you know, need more support, they can transition to those other levels of care and not have to find a new place to live. So it's fantastic.
Yeah.
It makes for a
yeah. And there's three restaurants there. I know we've had a few other folks on the air here with us. And I guess I'll ask then, since you're talking about the different levels of care, and that's great because you can stay at the same place. You'll know the faces. And believe me, the people that we've talked to that work at Unity, at the Village at Unity, they've been there for years. So that's so wonderful to me because who wants to see different people all the time? I mean, you get to know them like family. I know this. And I feel that when I go over there, they're just very settled and friendly. So tell the folks, Denise, what level of care, how do they know what they need? How do they start?
So honestly, I would recommend first speaking with an advisor, a sales advisor at a community that you're interested in. You know, be candid. Don't be afraid to talk about your challenges. We're going to be able to really navigate for you where we think you're best suited. At the end of the day, though, you know, if it comes down to a support need, care, we would have our health and wellness team, you know, do an evaluation if there's any question. And they're, you know, obviously better suited to say this is, you know, really where we think you're going to get the most support.
Right.
So speak to an advisor.
But ultimately, it's their decision, right?
I'm sorry?
Ultimately, it's the person's decision, though. I mean, you give them the options and you tell them what your recommendation is, but ultimately, it's the person's decision.
That's
right?
Absolutely correct. Yeah, it's absolutely right. And we can advise, and that's what we're supposed to do, but at the end of the day, that's absolutely right, up to the person.
Mm-hmm. And you know, as you say, there's the different levels of care, and it's important to be evaluated. But in addition to the care needs, you know, this is going to be somebody's new home, and so they, of course, need to be comfortable. How do you identify when a community is a good fit for someone?
So, you know, this is a great question. I actually kind of look at it as if, you know, you're buying a new home, right? So when you walk into a new home or a home that you're considering to purchase, you pretty much know within the first 90 seconds or so whether or not this has potential or whether or not it's not a good fit for you. So visit a community. I mean, that's the very first thing. You're going to get a certain vibe. You're going to get a certain feeling, and that's going to really help, you know, from there you'll be able to figure out whether or not I can see myself living here. You know, you definitely want to make sure that the community offers the services that you're, you know, interested in, that are most important to you and that you're going to benefit from. So, you know, you may have a good feeling, but if you need transportation and that's not something the community offers, you know, that's not going to be a good fit. So, you know,
sure.
You definitely want to consider the services as well. But talk to the people who live there. You know, look for signs of satisfaction. Are people smiling? Are they happy? Do they look like they're happy there? And that's going to, you know, also be a big contributor. But, you know, at the end of the day, if it makes you feel comfortable and the services are there, it's likely going to be a good fit.
Yes. Denise Nucci, you do a great job. And you're one of the sales advisors. So, folks, if you do want to, you know, get some more information or talk to someone that you kind of know already, you can call the Village at Unity and talk to Denise. What's the number, Denise?
It is 585-723-7442.
Awesome. Thanks for being with us. There's the music. We're going to break. It's the Village at Unity. It's a leisure care community, and that's a great name for it. It's a wonderful place. 1471 Long Pond Road in Rochester, New York. Go to thevillageatunity.com. Denise, have a great rest of your weekend. Celebrate that son of yours. And we're going to be going out to break here. But coming back, we have Tom Bruce. He will be talking to us about a new venue, 75 Stutson Street, which is going to be available to everybody for all kinds of different things. So stay tuned, and we'll tell you all about it.
In these uncertain times, we're all concerned with protecting our family's legacy and hard-earned assets from nursing home costs, unnecessary taxes, and the expense and delay of probate. At the Law Office of Michael Robinson, PC, we've spent over 34 years helping families just like yours preserve their wealth and leave a lasting legacy for those they love. Register for a free educational webinar to learn how you can protect you and your family. MRobinsonLaw.com. That's MRobinsonLaw.com.
Hot town, summer in the city. Back of my neck getting dirty and gritty. Bend down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead. Walking on the sidewalk harder than a match.
Welcome back to the Seniors Rock Show. If you're just tuning in, I'm attorney Mike Robinson, and Joanna Pelvino and I are now joined by our second guest today, Tom Bruce. And Tom is the owner of 75 Stutson Street, and he purchased that property 4 years ago. And it was a church. In fact, it was the first church in the Charlotte area, built in 1903. Tom purchased it to convert it into a multi-purpose building, mainly for music performance and education. Tom's mom was a piano teacher in Greece starting in 1954, and Tom played the trumpet, and the genes have continued to his daughter Wendy and granddaughter Jenna. They both teach piano and voice at 75 Stutson. The venue does have a rehearsal space for bands, including the Greece Performing Arts Orchestra, band and chorus. It's available for social events such as weddings, anniversaries, and dinner parties. You can find a listing of live shows at 75 Stutson Street on their website and Facebook page. So, Tom, welcome to the show.
Well, hello there. How are you guys doing today?
We're doing well. Hi, Tom. It's Joanna. I spoke to you on the phone, and it's nice to kind of meet you here on the air. And folks, if you want to see Tom, you can go to our Facebook page. But I guess we're going to start out with a basic question, and that is, Tom, tell us what 75 Stutson Street is now. I know Mike mentioned what it used to be, but I think there's quite a few different options there, and so I'd like you to tell the listeners.
Well, what we are is like I said, a multi-purpose building, which means that what we do is we teach music, obviously, as he said, too. And we also do things like we have two churches that hold services still in the building on Sunday mornings. We have a full kitchen so that we can have wedding receptions, and we can have everything from baby showers to funerals. So anything in between that you want to do that's, you know, you need a place for, we're big on teenage birthdays, for instance, because we make our auditorium look like a disco place. So some of the kids are back into that. If you guys remember when we had disco.
Oh, yeah.
It's a while ago, right? But since we're a senior citizen show, I think some of you may remember. But anyway, we do that kind of thing. We also, as mentioned, we have rehearsal spaces for bands, orchestras, choruses. I have on some evenings as many as 4 to 5 bands rehearsing at the same time.
Wow.
Well, the church had the part that was built in 1903 is the actual church part, which we also have a pipe organ, which is unusual in most churches today, a full pipe organ. And we have an auditorium that was a school built onto it actually in 1955. So when I purchased it, there was a daycare downstairs, which has since left. And in that daycare, we have built rehearsal spaces for bands and lessons and all that kind of stuff. So we've got a pretty big area for different bands to be rehearsing at the same time and different things going on all at the same time. So
you've got like different buildings like together with the separation being in that gives you the option to be able to have different music going on at the same time or different events.
Correct.
It's really interesting the way it's laid out.
Yes. And it's sort of neat because we can literally have a function going on in the auditorium part of it, such as, a band playing, or we've had some people doing dinners down there as far as like a spot type of dinner thing where they come in and they set up their dinner and bring in food and you know, it's a private type of situation in those cases. And they rent the space from us. So we have a bunch of different functions, I guess, is what I want to say. The other thing that's sort of interesting, I don't know if I mentioned it before, is I'm part of the Charlotte Community Association. In fact, I just became the vice president. And we hold some of our meetings there. And so another piece of it is that we're willing to do things with the school district, as you mentioned, the things with Rondacoit School District and the city school district. So becoming a place that's a social place, too.
I feel like it's a community center, Tom, really.
Well, it is. We also do voting. We're a voting place. So my whole function is to, or my whole idea of this is a retirement thing, which I'm not sure that's a good thing for retirement. Anyway, it's something that I want to have where people can come for any kind of a function. We don't charge a huge amount. In fact, sometimes I get in trouble because people yell at me for not, you know, like my wife, for not charging enough, but the function of the place is not for me to make a living anymore. Like I say, I'm retired. So the main function is to be a social place for people to come, enjoy themselves. If people need a place for a social meeting, we try to keep it way down in cost if we can. And in some cases, if it's a youth type of thing, in fact, tonight, I should probably mention it, we're having a group that is housed in our place that I helped start along with a man named Tommy Allen, which is called the All In Brass Band. Nice. And we are having our fundraiser for the year where we're trying to raise some money for the band because it's a nonprofit band for kids from everywhere, henceforth the name All In. We have kids all the way from 9 years old to adults that are 70 years old that participate in this band where the kids are the key, but we have people that work as mentors. And in fact, we've actually had some of the kids that started out as young teenagers that are now mentors because they're older. And we try to play for social events. Last week, they played at the Lighthouse down in Charlotte. We've played for different events like the Heart Association. And we've even gone to New York to play for events where... Yeah, so it's a good it's a
what
good
time does it start tonight?
Tonight it starts at 5 o'clock actually.
Do they have to get tickets ahead of time or anything? We've got only another minute or two, so I want to make sure you tell us where you are and all that. But tell them how they can get the in tonight.
Okay, they can come to 75 Stetson Street, which is down in Charlotte. It's the street beyond where the lift bridge is there, the O'Rourke Bridge. And off of Lake Avenue on Stetson Street, and it's the second church on the street. It's sort of unusual because there's two next to each other, but it's a brick church. You can get tickets there. It starts at 5 with 2 hours of youth groups.
Nice.
The kids have put together their own little rock bands and bands, and then we come on with our all-in brass band does a piece, and then we have another band that comes in never the same that comes in to play later. So you get a full night of music for a very small amount of money. So
yeah, what a cool thing to
see
do.
We'd love to see people come in.
Thank you. You know what I'm hearing? I'm hearing passion here, and that's what you're supposed to do in retirement. So don't you worry about doing the right thing, Tom.
Well, I get, and I do have a passion for it. It's been my thing. I had a friend that came in at one point, a musician, who announced that, well, Tom told me about this 35 years ago. He was talking about doing this, so he finally did it.
And it's a, Tom, it's a great idea, great venue. Thanks for doing it. We got to go to break here, and we'll be back after break. Wrap up another hour of the Seniors Rock Radio Show on News Radio WHAM 1180.
When you've lost movement, flexibility, strength, or balance, traveling a long distance for physical therapy seems like a bad decision. That's why Agape Physical Therapy has a convenient location near you, east side or west side. And there's a new location in Pittsford with Aqua Therapy. Let Agape Physical Therapy and wellness professionals customize a treatment program for you to help you recover quickly. Visit agapephysicaltherapy.com and schedule your free consultation today. No doctor referral needed.
See the curtains hanging in the window in the evening of a Friday night. Little light is shining through the window, lets me know everything's alright. Summer breeze makes me feel fine, blowing through the jasmine in my mind.
And welcome back to the Seniors Rock Show. We've been saluting a hot summer a little bit with our music bumps today. And Joanna, here we are. It's almost the end of another show.
Yeah. Can you believe it? Again, you know, I'm always shocked by that because it does go by quick. And thank you folks that are listening and stayed with us for the hour. I hope you'll come back next week as well. And what's going on? I don't have to ask you what you're doing at 1 o'clock today.
Well, I'm going to be doing some work, but I'll have the game on the radio, so I'll be listening, not watching.
Mm-hmm. And for you folks that are out of the area, we're talking about the Bills game. Big, big stuff this year. We are going to win the Super Bowl, right? Right? Positive?
Yeah, so I'm not even going to bother watching. It's going to happen.
Pam's got her hat on. We are good to go. So that's fun. And there's a lot of things going on. Actually, this Friday is the Salute to Seniors concert down at Ontario Beach Park. We were talking about the beach, and that's rain or shine. So get your umbrella out and don't be a pansy. Get out there and have some fun. There's all seniors are welcome. You won't melt, like my dad used to say. And you can bring your own lawn chair, and there's vendors and fun, all kinds of things. You'll probably see a lot of great members there, and that's the Greater Rochester Area Partnership for the Elderly. They will be sprinkled through the crowd and with the vendors because many of them work with the companies that you'll see there. And those meetings, by the way, Mike, are going to start up again in September. So if you're interested in finding out more about GRAPE, you can go to grapeelder.org. And it's a wonderful organization of people who are dedicated to seniors, everybody from, you know, the U of R to Mr. Grab Bar and everyone in between. So it's an awesome organization. And another organization that we really like here on Seniors Rock Radio is Lifespan. And a reminder that they're always looking for volunteers. And it's, you know, they're 100 strong already, but they can always use more. So the programs they have are outstanding. They reach out into many of the counties around Rochester. So if you'd like to help others and you'd like to do something with some passion, please call them. And the number for Lifespan is 585-244-8400. And just Google Lifespan and you'll see their website pop up. So what else is going on this weekend, Mike?
Well, you know, I know there's a lot of folks who are headed out to the Ukrainian festival this weekend, and today especially great weather for it. Just make sure you stay hydrated. The Flower City Brewers Fest is at the Public Market, I believe, this weekend.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And so that's always a lot of fun, a lot of beverages, but there's beer trucks food trucks. And such as well. Yeah. I'm sure there are.
Yeah. And today's World Honey Bee Day. So there might be some honey beers. Not honey bears, honey beers. I don't want to get anybody scared. And there is another thing that we didn't mention today. It's kind of cool. National Radio Day. Did you know that, Pam? Who knew? I didn't see it anywhere.
I did not know that. No.
Oh, next year we'll have to put it on social media. And, okay, so if you're traveling, it's a good thing. National Accessible Air Travel Day. How that happens, I'm not sure. But that sounds good for me. I mean, if you're traveling. And one other thing. This is a good one. National Chocolate Pecan Pie Day. Do you say pecan or pecan?
You know, I'll say it both ways.
Depending on your mood?
Exactly, exactly. So, but I guess if you're from Rochester, you need to say pecan.
Pecan. That's funny. And Pam, what's up? You got your Bills hat on. I know that you're going to be listening to the game. I think you might be working for a little bit, but what else is going on?
Not too much. My husband is hiking in the Adirondacks this weekend. So it's just me and Lucy this weekend. So we're going to have a little girls weekend, do something fun with my sister and my mom.
Nice. Very nice. Well, that's great. Well, we have the public markets and You know, the things, usually there's things on Sundays now too, to throughout the season, because it is kind of a short season, but I love the Brighton Farm Market. They have music. And if you haven't been to that one, Pam, check that out too.
I haven't,
and
then, but that sounds awesome.
Yeah. In Irondequoit, I just saw a sign. I think that was yesterday. I don't know if it's today, but they have music and they have local artisans. So it makes me want to go around and check all the different farmers markets and support them. And there is a lot to do here in the summer and in the winter, if you get out of the house. And we know, you know, the Seniors Rock Show is here to remind you that aging, you know, is an asset, and that you can have some fun and get out and do things. And it's really healthy for you. And, you know, I'm dealing with some arthritis. I mentioned that before. I know some of my friends are. And I think it's cool that we're just kind of, you know, taking the attitude of let's just keep moving and take care of ourselves and see how long we can, you know, keep it at bay, so to speak, because you can't, you know, it's aging. It's just what it is. Right, Mike?
Exactly. And it's nothing to fight against. You know, you just want to keep yourself healthy with getting out and moving. And yeah, you can get out and enjoy all that the area has to offer.
Yeah. And tell them what to do while they're doing that.
All right. Well, hey, have fun while you're doing it, of course. And as always, be well and be kind.
And thank you for joining us today. Thank you to our sponsors. And I hope you'll come back next week, because we will be here until we meet again. Keep in mind, friends, that age is an asset, and that seniors rock.